it's become what I think what it should have been, a consumer-centric business because of the laws that have changed, new policies that have come in. It's making it more a service industry, which it should be. Consumer should be assured now that whatever he's promised, he will get. And for developers, is also that whatever you promise, nobody can over-promise and under-deliver and cut your market. So I think that's a great change that's happened. You know, what we noticed is that when we were doing our CRM audits or you know, our whenever we used to get data in terms of telephones or emails from consumers, before it was a very different journey. Before, his journey was directly calling us after an ad, maybe coming to the office, and over a couple of meetings or 3 to 4 meetings, we closed the deal. Today, one big difference that has happened is that once he sees your ad, the first place he goes to the internet. And you know, reputed sites like Magic Bricks, all these, and some consumer forums is where he first finds out about the developer, finds out about what he's doing with people already with him, and then he comes to you. So now we've noticed that we're sitting with somebody who's well informed, and we don't really need to tell him more about the project because he knows it all. And he's now ready to talk to you on what deal are you ready to give him and close the deal. So I would say that from yesteryears to today, the difference is a much educated customer, which helps developers like us who really want to deliver honestly and sometimes not on time, but a product which we've shown. Absolutely, you know, the difference would be that what you delivered last would be your story. I mean, you cannot rest on your past laurels where you can say 10 years ago I delivered something. It would be your last project. It would be the last consumer experience that you created for your customers. That's going to be a big effect on the future customer. You know, things have changed. Like for example, Noida came up with a rule that if you were to go platinum, lead platinum in your development, lead gold, sorry, then you get about 0.5% FAR free. What that did is that the offset of you know, doing platinum or gold buildings was taken care of with the extra FAR. But what you've now got in Noida, especially in the city center project, is a completely environmentally friendly and environmentally sustained project. You know. So a very great change what policy made into the market. Moving forward, the way RERA is formed, it's changing the way deliveries and promises will match up now. You know, it's a great platform for us. We think it's an absolute perfect platform for any dispute resolution or any query which we may not be able to make the consumer understand. So it's a great platform to come together, sit in front of very highly decorated and highly efficient and experienced officers who understand you know, from both ends, from the developer's end and from the buyer's end. Because today, saying things like to a developer of giving higher interest than what RERA has confirmed and giving payments, right, down payments for refunds is not the way to go, because you have to understand that we're building, all the refunds come from equity, not from any loans. So we want to make sure that we obviously honor our mistakes which is delay, but we want to honor it today according to RERA, because we have to also build for the thousands of other customers as well. So I think RERA is the great way forward by the government, and I think over time a parity should reach where that would be the exclusive platform where developers and their consumers talk. Whatever's happened has happened. But the way we see it moving forward, for Wave, because we are generally in the markets, you know, in the price ranges of EMI of between 5,000 rupees to about 150,000 rupees a month. Thereby meaning, you know, we're not at very high end of the market. We are rather from the lower spectrum to the middle spectrum of the market. The way we see it going forward, is taking a page from the American regulators, where you cannot take more than 10% from a buyer and he has to get a home loan for the rest 90%. Now we see this as the only saving grace, so that, you know, investment in real estate, we always saw, was always a long-term prospect. You bought something for your children, and then when they matured enough, there was enough capital gains for them to take something home, so to say. In the last decade or so, it became a thing like stock market, you know, where people wanted to flip it within 3 to 4 months, and that caused a lot of stress as well, because a lot of payments did not come from these people who thought they could flip it. Now, the one thing that the change that is that's good, that we think that we want to implement in our projects is take 10% from the buyer, rest, he has to get a home loan, so thereby you filter in the, you know, so to say, investors who want an early flip, so you filter that. On the second is that you could construct and then send your bills to the banks, and the bankers could send you the money according to the construction that is linked. Moving beyond that, there are too many variables on some, not all, but at least some consumers not paying on time. Now all of this affects the project time. Banks, as you know, today are, you know, moving slowly, they're coming back to construction financing, but it's going to take a while before, you know, everything settles in. We have SBI, we have PSB, we have Yes Bank, you know, who we work with, and purely on construction loans. But moving forward, I think the way has to be that home loan companies are the ones that are giving out the payouts for construction in time, not consumers, not other resources which were used at very high interest. All these have to, you know, move out, and there has to be more discipline on home, you know, bankers, developers and buyers, mind you, not investors, sitting on the same platform and talking. Beyond that, because again, for a consumer, once a bank approves a project in terms of home loan, he's also secured that all the due diligence that is required is done very thoroughly, and then the bank approval for a project comes. Moving forward, the way we are seeing our sales and marketing strategies will be focused towards end users, and investors are more than welcome who understand and appreciate that real estate is a long-term investment. It is safe, I would still say, and we believe that it is the safest investments compared to gold, equities, and you can see them in long term. Real estate has always given us better results. Real estate is also a place where, you know, you cannot encash so fast. It becomes like a very safe place to hold family wealth. So for them and for end users, because we concentrate ourselves on making sure how do we reduce their operating cost, how do we make most of the space that, you know, we are giving them. So we are going to be focused on people who want to take a loan, who want to remain here, or, you know, want to take a shop and open their franchises, or, you know, their own brand. Focus will be to end users rather than being towards short-term investors. I don't think today, what for us it was the mantra that you have to deliver what you promise, but the governments make sure that everybody has to do that now. So I think it's a big win for both the consumers and honest developers.